virtual hello and hug, because we're not allowed to do that in person for another 2 more weeks, apart from the week that we had left already. Did anyone else have a moment when Cyril said 2 more weeks? Was it just me? Possibly just me. But I'm not gonna lie, guys, I'm gonna be very real. I've been super chilled about the lockdown up until last night. Last night I had a moment of, I don't really know. Man, it's like, I don't know if it's just because I'm lockdowning on my own, if you didn't know. I'm doing this on my own, not because I didn't have options. I could have stayed with family. I had friends who offered for me to come stay by them. And part of me really wanted to, actually really wanted to take them up on that offer. But before lockdown started officially, I just took a moment and I was like, okay, God, who do you want to be for me during lockdown? You know, let me not miss what you're doing. And so I was just like, okay, God, who do you want to be for me? Do you want to be the God who provides community for me in this, in the form of a place to go? Do you want to be the God who meets me when I'm all alone? Like, what are you doing? What are we doing? What are we talking about? What's going on? So that I am in the right space for what you want to do. And it didn't take very long, and I already felt the Lord laid on my heart, like, Lelani, I want to be for you the God who is present, the God who is there. And I realized, like, to really experience that, I need to be on my own so that he's my only option. And so I took the brave decision. 3 weeks isn't so bad. I mean, it's 21 days. There's video calls, there's Skype, there's Zoom. We have options, people. We really have options. But when 21 days all of a sudden gets extended, and I must say, yesterday, for the first time really in the last 2 weeks, I could feel the walls closing in on me. I could feel like this is a tiny space and it's really starting to get to me. And so to receive that news last night, I had a little freak out. I did. I had a wobbly, guys. I had a real wobbly. I cried. I messaged some friends. I'm like, guys, you need to pray because I'm feeling it. I am feeling it. And so thankfully, I have people like that in my life. But I actually just wanted to share a little something of what's been getting me through, just because I know that I'm not the only one doing this on my own. And doing it on your own already is, it's tough, nay? It's tough. But I also know that I know a lot of people who freelance, whose work and livelihood actually depend on needing to see people, and that's how they get an income. And so I'm so thinking of all of my friends and people who I know who, and people who I don't know, let's be real. This is a universal thing that affects all of us. And I'm so thinking of anyone whose livelihood is being impacted by this, because I can understand how that fear can crawl in. Because 3 weeks is bad, but when those 3 weeks turns into 5 weeks, I mean, it's the whole month of April. I mean, let's think about that. It's the whole month of April. And it's hectic. And so I'm really thinking of everyone. And so I want to share this, because this is what I've been holding on to. And that I had to re-hold onto again this morning and last night. and it's this psalm that the Lord laid on my heart from the very beginning of lockdown. And it's Psalm 27, actually. And I want to just share a little bit with you, and I hope it encourages you, because it's really been encouraging me. Okay. And it's very simple and it's very short, I promise. Psalm 27 starts like this in the NLT translation, which is what I read normally. It says, the Lord is my light and my salvation, so why should I be afraid? The Lord is my fortress, protecting me from danger, so why should I tremble? Right? The psalm goes on. It's so good. Read the whole thing. But even just in that, that is what caught me. And I felt the Lord just say, do you maybe want to pay attention to what your role is and what my role is in this psalm? And when you look at it, it says, the Lord is my light and my salvation. So the Lord's job is to save me. The Lord's job is to light my path in this. The Lord's job is to like not leave me in darkness in the season. That's his job. My job is to not be afraid, right? The Lord is my fortress, protecting me from danger. So why should I tremble? His job is to protect me. His job is to keep me safe. His job is to really just be that protection over me. And I feel like if it's over me, it's over my finances, it's over my business, it's over all of it, you know? That's his job. My job is not to tremble. So I quite had a moment of, oh, right, I'm kind of like taking your position here by freaking out and panicking a little bit. And I just felt like it just put me in my place in quite a beautiful, friendly way of just, listen, girl, you just focus on not being afraid because I got you covered. And all those things you're panicking about, it's actually my job and I've got it sorted. So I've been very, very encouraged by that. Just that little bit of remember what is my responsibility, what's God's responsibility, and just staying in my lane. Nay, because I do tend to veer sometimes and start taking on responsibility that's never meant to be mine. So that's been really encouraging me. I've been holding on to that, and I really just wanted to share that for anyone else who needs it, because I know we're hardly ever like alone in what we struggle with, and I really kind of battled to wrap my head around 3 more weeks of being on my own. Guys, I've got a physical touch love language now. I just need a really big hug from someone, and the amount of signs that I see everywhere that says you have to be 1 meter apart, I'm like, yes, amen, this is great, but also I really would just love a hug. You know what I mean? Anyone else that can relate, please tell me it's not just me. But I just wanted to share that. I hope it encourages you. If you've got anything that has been getting you through, I actually want to hear. Please share with me, friends. Share with me, because you guys are wise. I know such smart people. So please share with me what's been getting you through. Yeah. How's the lockdown life, guys? How's the lockdown life? Anyway, that's been getting me through is staying in my lane and remembering what is my job and what's God's job and keeping it at that. Okay, gang, love y'all. Can't wait for a big group hug. The whole Insta family. We'll invite the whole Insta family. Why not?